No, it doesn't work. It doesn't work if you actually cheer. No, stop it. This is a lot like all the CD release shows we did before Southeastern came
I
out.
I like seeing all the folks tuned in.
Hey, everybody, I see y'all. That's a nice chandelier. Hello, young lady. Hey, wavy arms. I like those arms. Those are good. Hey, young man. Woo, having a good time.
Look at that cat.
This crowd is ready. This crowd is primed. Aww. He looks so happy. Is that a live animal? No, that's a stuffed. Oh, thank God. I thought that was a live animal, but that's a stuffed animal. Anyway, I'm Jason Isbell. This is Amanda Shires. Thank you all very much for tuning in on your Friday night. I don't know how many options you had, but I know there are other things you could have been doing. We have a new album. It came out today. It's called Reunions. It's on our own Southeastern Records label with the help of our friends at 30 Tigers. And I am proud of it. It's exciting. It's strange to put a record out now, but it feels good. It feels like I'm taking something that I believe in and throwing it loose in the world. My wife, Amanda, helped me a great deal on this album, and she's going to help me a great deal tonight to perform these songs for you.
Oh, wait.
Ready?
Wait, no. It's been a minute. Since
hold on.
We've
got to plug that fiddle in. This is an electric show. Been playing around the house, but you don't have to plug the fiddle in. Amanda Shires on the electric fiddle.
Thank you.
What if I got down? What have I done to help somebody save me? What have I done to help? What have I done to help but not myself? What have I done to help? What have I done to help somebody save me? What have I done to help? What have I done to help but not myself? I thought I was alone in the world till my memories gathered around me in the night. Thought I was strong until I finally had to fight. Kept my head down, showed up to work on time. Watch my appetite. Put the money in the mattress. Lock your doors at night and we'll all be alright. What have I done to help? What have I done to help somebody save me? What have I done to help? What have I done to help? Not myself. What have I done to help? What have I done to help somebody save me? What have I done to help? What have I done to help and not myself? See, I've made mistakes that I can't erase. Some of the love I've lost will not come back to me. I broke my word. Light on a Bible just to feel a little free. She didn't deserve it. Nobody ever deserves it. But I cut anchor and I drifted out to sea. You found me busted. Somehow you trusted I was not what I could be. But what have I done to hell? What have I done to help somebody save me? What have I done to help? What have I done to help not myself? What have I done to help? What have I done to help somebody save me?
have I done to hell? What have I done to hell but not myself? Come to safety, you and me and the babe. Send our thoughts and prayers to loved ones on the ground. As the days went by, we just stopped looking down, down, down. Now the world's on fire, and we just climb higher till we're no longer bothered by the smoke and sound. The good people suffer, and your heart gets tougher. Nothing given, nothing found. What have I done to hell? What have I done to help somebody save me? What have I done to help? What have I done to help not myself? What have I done to help? What have I done to help somebody save me? What have I done to help? What have I done to help but not myself?
Thank you very much. Amanda Shires on the violin. You can clap now. There's a few people up there running cameras and wearing masks. let me tune.
I know I shouldn't probably say anything, but I really love this interactive where we can see everybody.
Yeah,
we didn't
cool.
have that with my barn show.
No.
It's awesome. Everybody looks really happy and cozy. I'm glad y'all are hanging in there.
Got some friends watching. Mr. Patterson Hood, he and his wife Rebecca are celebrating their anniversary by watching at home right now.
Aww.
Patterson of the Drive-By Truckers, they just put out a real fine record recently.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary, you guys. I was there. I saw you fall in love.
Did you?
I did.
How did they fall in love when you saw it?
Just at first sight.
Really?
Yeah, first time I saw them, they fell in love. It was very sweet. It was very sweet. Rebecca had this white jacket with fringe on it.
And you knew she was the one.
I was like, man, Patterson's going to love that. And he did. He's a man who loves fringe but never wears it. Guess we're leaving town again. We're moving out, moving in. Gotta break the news to all my friends, but they won't care. They'll just find another face to fall behind and take my place. Run well past second base and just stand there. A dream sickle on a summer night in a folding low chair. Witches ring around the moon, better get home soon. Poison oak, poison ivy, dirty jokes that blew right by me. Mama curling up beside me, crying to herself. Why can't daddy just come home, forget whatever he did wrong? He's in a hotel all alone and we need help.
bicycle on a summer night in a morning hotel. I'm still packing up my room, gotta get home soon. New sneakers on the high school court, and you swore you'd be there. Heart breaking through the springtime, breaking into June. I'll be 18 4 years from now, with different friends in a different town. I'll finally be free. Call you boss on holiday, tell you why I moved away. Say everything's gonna be okay, you can come see me. A dream sickle on a summer night in a folding chair. Daddy's howling. Heat lightning in the evening sky, and my mama's red hair. Heart breaking through the springtime, breaking into June. Breaking into June. Breaking into June.
So you are with us at the Brooklyn Bowl in Nashville, Tennessee. This is the first time the Brooklyn Bowl has hosted a performance, so we're honored to be the first people to play here. There are bowling lanes over here. I don't think you can see those, but they're there. Some of my friends that are here working, they went over and they bowled in very separate lanes, standing very far apart, and had a good time. It almost felt like normal, so that was nice. It's good to look at a bowling lane when things are weird, I've noticed. We're raising money for Music Cares COVID-19 Relief Fund and for my crew. And so if you donate to us, we'll split the money, go some up to my crew, some up to COVID-19 Relief Fund. And then whatever we give to the COVID Relief Fund, Spotify is going to match, which I think is very cool. Thank you, Spotify. If you feel like donating and if you can, please do that. I promise I won't keep any of the money.
just to explain, Music Cares is a wonderful organization that helps folks in the music industry, whether they're artists, musicians, or crew, or tour managers. I'm trying to explain this in easy terms. Just folks that work in the business. They help you with everything from paying your doctor bills to helping you pay your dental bills, like.
If your car breaks down, they'll help you. They will help you pay to fix your car.
It's really a great thing.
They help you go to rehab.
They helped us with rehab. They helped me when I broke my finger. They've helped some of my friends when they've done crazy things on the road on accident, like try to make a sandwich and cut their finger, or you know.
Avocado.
It's a real organization, and it's touched a lot of our real friends' lives and ourselves as well. So thank you so much.
Yes, and if you're a musician or if you're somebody who works in the music business and you're having a hard time right now, reach out to Music Cares and they will help you. I see a sign. Somebody's holding up a sign. Oh, look at that Buck Owens guitar. He's playing along. That's fun. I hadn't thought about that.
That's a good idea.
Something you can't really do at a show is bring your guitar and play along.
No, but that's genius.
I have seen people do it, but
there are...
It's much more acceptable here. Good job, sir. You sound great. I can't hear you, but you sound great.
Your soul sounds great. There's some more signs.
Walking around at night, fighting my appetite. Every kid in cutoffs could be you. Remember when we used to meet at the bottom of Mobile Street, do what the broken people do. Are you still taking notes? Holy Ghost could get inside you. You do whatever you put your mind to. Will you read me what you wrote? We were locked outside the building, over-encouraged only children. Coffee on the fire escape, bet it all on a demo tape. We still had something left to steal. Remember when we took too much to get a little of the human touch, hand to mouth, reel to reel. Are you still taking notes? Hydrocodone in your backpack. Maybe these words will hold the beast back. Will you read me what you wrote? What I said you stole from Dylan, over-encouraged only children. Heaven's wasted on the dead. That's what your mama said while her hearse was idling in the parking lot. Said you thought the world of me, and you were glad to see they finally let me be an astronaut. You have anyone to talk to? Castle walls that you can walk through. Do the dead believe in ghosts? Or are you lost in some old building with over-encouraged only children?
Thank you. That song's called Only Children. Thank you, guys. On the album version of that, David Crosby came and sang with us, and he sang so beautifully. I think I heard some audience. Hey, guys, I think I heard y'all. I think I just heard you guys say something. You guys look great. I'm glad you're sitting outside. It's beautiful. Somebody grilling some food. You guys are gaming. That looks fun. So on the album version of that song, David Crosby came and sang with us, and that was a real honor and a real treat. We got to spend some time with David and Amanda, and me and David got to stand in the studio and sing harmony together. Felt like we were in a different time.
Yeah, I think in that night you had to fly somewhere crazy? Remember the days of flying?
Yeah, I flew in an airplane, and I only washed my hands 77 times. It was amazing the old days, back in my day. But I flew up to play a benefit for the Ally Coalition. Jack Antonoff was throwing a show up in New York City, so I flew up to do that. I had a fantastic time at that. Jack's a great person. We had a good time making music together. But in the meantime, you took David Crosby to dinner in East Nashville.
Yes.
And what did David Crosby do?
Man, he was so cool. He was everything you hoped David Crosby would be. We walked in. Sam drove us. We hopped out. And as we sat down, he just lit up what they call a doobie.
He lit up a doobie.
In the middle of the restaurant.
Right in the middle of the restaurant.
And it was awesome. I was like looking around waiting for somebody to say something, and I was going to be like, it's okay, this is my friend.
And everybody was like, no, no, it's David Crosby. We figured he'd do that.
Yeah, exactly. It was awesome.
David Crosby, Willie Nelson, and Snoop Dogg are like the three people who could just go in and light up a joint in a restaurant.
And you're like, well.
Yeah, not much I can do about this. Because all three of them could probably whoop your ass.
Yeah, I believe it.
Willie Nelson knows a lot of karate. And he's also so high. Like, okay, for example, on a run of shows a few years ago, we were opening for Willie Nelson. We were playing with Willie Nelson and Alison Krauss in Union Station. Really super fun run. Some beautiful music. And after a couple shows, Amanda finished her tour, and she flew in to join us.
No, I was at school.
Oh, you were. She was at Sewanee, University of the South. And she flew in to join us, and she got up on stage for the encore at the end of the night, and we were all playing. And then she played a fiddle solo, and Willie Nelson walked up and took his bandana off and put it on her head, and then he kissed her right on the mouth.
I was about to pull. I thought my fiddle case was right there because I have that bandana in it. Yeah.
After the show, she said, so Willie Nelson kissed me right on the mouth. And I was like, are you okay with that? And she was like, well, yeah, it's Willie Nelson, but are you okay with that? And I was like, well, yeah, it's Willie Nelson. First of all, it's Willie Nelson. And second of all, you don't know what somebody's going to do when they're that high. Like, they don't fight normal. They might have, like, a rock in their hand that they forgot they had and drop it on your foot. Or they might just, like, I don't know, punch you in the shoulder really, really hard. And then while you're laughing, like, really fight you. You never know what's going to happen.
They could plus, just kiss you.
He wrote Angel Flying Too Close to the Ground. So if she's good with it, I'm good with it. Willie, if you're watching, Lucas, if you're watching, tell your dad we're cool with it. We're cool with it.
I mean, we were before Corona.
Yeah. Now, please, nobody kiss us.
Don't touch your face.
Man, I just thought I feel bad for those folks who are having extramarital affairs right now.
You mean like virtually?
No, I mean like in reality. Because then, like, you know, you got to sneak out to see your lover. We need to write like a bunch of sort of yacht rock type of songs about that. For the next album we'll be doing while in quarantine, it's going to be in the style of Billy Ocean, and it's going to be about sneaking out of the house to socially distance an affair with your part-time lover.
I could think of different subjects that might be as good.
I've already committed to it on the internet,
okay,
though.
Okay, all right.
We're done. That's it.
Okay. Fine.
So the streak will be broken.
Are you going to actually go through with these hypothetical affairs that you're going to be having?
No, no, I'm not going to be having any affairs. I'm a songwriter. I make this stuff. This is I'm a creator of stories.
Because if this is what's happening right now, we should call the New York Times.
Oh, yeah, no, they probably would already know. They would have told us. Okay. They would have been like, Jason, do you realize you're having an affair? The only lady that's ever come between us is old and gray. That's what they call the New York Times, the old gray lady.
Oh, okay, okay.
Anyway.
Well, we didn't know that.
No, that was a great article, and he did a good job with that. If you guys want to read it, go online and read it. Anyway, let's do a... Sound of the highway died. There's ashes in the swimming pool.
I saw you on your wedding night, and I watched you sleeping in my arms. And you didn't wash your makeup off. You woke up looking scared as hell. My love won't change, my love won't change, my love won't change a thing. You're never coming back to me. You're never coming back at all. And the waiter made a young girl cry at the table next to mine tonight. And I know you would have brought him to his knees, but you're overseas. Doesn't seem so long ago we thought that we could change their minds. We'd stay here and fight it out with a love that we could weaponize. But I saw you losing faith, and I was watching when the light went out. And you know what revolution means. You know it's not an option now. 'Cause our love won't change, our love won't change, our love won't change a thing. I couldn't leave my father here to finish up his life alone. And I saw you in a daughter's eyes last night when she caught me in love. And I need you here to make both of us believe, but you're overseas.
Amanda says, congratulations. I know it's not what you hoped, but it's awesome. And thank you very much. Thank you for understanding that. Because it is weird as shit. This is weird. If you got little kids, tell them don't say shit if you want to. But I'm going to say it again. This is weird as shit.
I like to say it's an acronym. SHPI in transit. It's not really a bad word.
It's not a bad word. No words are bad. Just all the people. It feels really weird to put a record out right now, but it would feel weirder to not put a record out. And it would feel like I wasn't being myself and being true to myself. And it's also a luxury because I can put a record out when I don't have to go tour behind it. I mean, I need to, and I would love to,
yeah.
But I can put it out right now and let the record go and let the songs breathe and do their work. And so I'm very grateful for that. But also it's good for me because when I make a record, I make it about my life and how my life is then, and my life changes. And so I don't want to wait a year and then talk about what my life was like.
As a listener to music, separate from our intertwined lives. When people put new music out during this time, it brings so much good to my life on the daily. And I know we could use more records, so I'm glad yours is out now.
Thank you.
Because I'm one of those people that does the, you know, New Music Friday, yeah. And I listen to everything.
She's a religious new music.
All
listener.
The genres. And if it weren't for folks being brave and having some trust and hope, then there'd be a lot of folks like me that were a lot sadder jumping out of windows. So okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for that. And thank you for helping me make the album and encouraging me to release it. Thanks for helping me play it tonight.
I just want you to know how important it is.
Well, thank you. It's important to me also, because I couldn't imagine. It would be terrible to get a record done and be so proud of it, and then it's like, nah, sorry, hold up, we gotta wait another year. That would be terrible.
And then it would be all not even like relative.
Yeah, sometimes the leftovers aren't better. This is not a pot of chili. This is not your grandmama's lasagna. The leftovers aren't better. We need it fresh, and we need it now.
Yeah, we do. Yeah, you're right.
Oh, let's do this one. I forgot.
Okay.
Took forever to get you to trust me, like I was beating a bird with my hand. And if this isn't love, then it must be another answer I don't understand. To a wish that I made on a satellite, to a question I wrote in the sand. That's it. That's the next line. I need to start this over.
I would love that to happen anyway. I love this one so much.
It's good. Okay. This is the first time I've performed these songs with an audience.
Even if it wasn't, you get to do what you want.
Yeah.
Start
it's
over.
Free music Friday. You're about to get some free music. Took forever to get you to trust me, like I was beating a bird from my hand. And if this isn't love, then it must be another answer I don't understand. To a prayer that was please and not thank you, to a question I wrote in the sand, to a wish that I made on a satellite, from a witness and tears on the stand. We can never go back and be strangers. All our secrets are mixed and distilled. But you taught me to temper my anger, and you learned it's alright to be still. Running with our eyes closed. Running with our eyes closed. Nice. Nice fiddle playing. Thank you. Let's see here. Now, on the next song, River, I played the piano on that song and sang. Dave Cobb made me. I started playing on the piano. That was what I did wrong. And I'm not a very good piano player, but Dave Cobb made me play it on the piano and sing it at the same time. Because, you know, he was producing, man. That's why we call him Good Job Dave Cobb.
He's got an interesting way about doing things like that because it brings a person into the moment, you know?
Yeah, he doesn't want to capture a performance as much as
he wants to.
He
wants you to have your heart and soul and frustrations in it.
Yes, he wants to capture creation.
I mean, the only thing worse would be that the piano would be red.
Yeah, yeah, it would be. But
like
it worked.
Like a bit like Crisis.
Yeah. Yeah, like a red Corvette.
Yeah.
Little red Bussendorfer. But it wasn't. It was an upright piano in the studio. And we played it live, and that was fun. Let's do it. River is my savior. She used to be a cloud. She's happy just to lay there when she used to be so proud. And even when she dries up a thousand years from now, I'll lay myself beside her and call her name out loud. River is my savior, only one I'll ever need. Wash my head when I've been sinning, wash my knuckles when they bleed. And protect me from my neighbor, all his jealousy and greed. Take the body to the delta and hide the weapon in the weed. But now I'm tired and a little bit confused regarding what I meant to do and what I did. And then I'm hired. They all seem to be afraid of me. They turn their eyes away from me like. River hears my secrets, things I cannot tell a soul. Like the children that I've orphaned and the fortune that I stole. And the neighbor who asks questions till he washed up on the shore. But I've done the law some favors so nobody has to know. But I'm tired and I just can't get to sleep. I've been a wolf among these sheep for all my. Lick of fire, it consumes me in my dreams. Last night I woke up screaming at my wife. The river is my savior, she's running to the sea. To reach her destination is to simply cease to be. Running till you're nothing sounds a lot like being free. So I'll lay myself inside her and I'll let her carry me. Thank you.
have been testing you, and you fail. See how long that you can sit with the truth, but you bail. And I don't think you even recognize the loss of control, and I don't think you even see it in yourself. See, every one of us is counting dice that we didn't roll, and the loser is the last to ask for help. Be afraid, very afraid. Do it anyway. Do it anyway. Be afraid, very afraid. Do it anyway. Do it anyway. The stage belongs to you, and you feel like a star. And you can bark and snap like a dog at the man who just tuned your guitar. But I don't think you even recognize the kid in the wings, and I don't think you even see her in yourself. She looks to you for what to do with all her delicate dreams, but you're too terrified to be of any help. Be afraid, be very afraid, but do it anyway. Do it anyway. Be afraid, be very afraid. Do it anyway. Do it anyway. We don't take requests. We won't shut up and sing. Tell the truth enough. You find it rhymes with everything. We've been testing you. You failed. To see how long that you could hold it in before you scream, but you only exhale. And I don't think you even recognize the sound of your voice when it's blasting through the speakers in the sky. And if your words add up to nothing, then you're making a choice to sing a cover when we need a battle cry. Be afraid, be very afraid. Do it anyway. Do it anyway.
Thank you. Thank you. The song that I'm about to play, this is Water. The song that I'm about to play, I wrote after a friend of ours and someone who'd been close to Amanda for a lot of years committed suicide. And so if you want to talk about the helpline a little bit, I would love that. That would be great.
I know that there's a lot of folks out there that struggle with mental illness. It's not an easy thing to talk about or even call a helpline for. But I could tell you that if you do call a helpline like 1-800-237-HELP, and hopefully I got those numbers not mixed up, that it's an easy thing to do. And I want you to know, if you don't know it right now, you are worth it, and you're valuable, and nobody wants you to go out like that. So, for Neil Casal, and for folks that might be having a hard time now, or they might not have ever seen themselves in a position where they're alone, like they are now, I highly recommend it. You don't have to have a clinical depression or any kind of like diagnosed problems, but if you need help, these folks will answer the phone. And your longest wait time is 30 seconds max. That's all I wanted to say.
That's good. Thank you for saying that, because it's hard. It's hard. It's hard right now for a whole lot of people. What do I do to make you smile? You've been hurting for a while. Let me start that over. I don't need this capo, so I'm just going
to
take it off.
I was about to say that you didn't record any of this record with the capo.
Yeah,
so
I told people on Twitter. I told Corey Brannon on
his interview. I think you just might have grabbed it out of habit.
It's a security capo. It's like my, it's like your thunder blanket.
That's,
it's
like
my thunder
set list. I need a security set list.
That's my thunder capo.
Yeah.
Smile, you've been hurting for a while. What can I do to make you laugh? Get St. Peter's autograph. What's that distance in your eye? Has your faith been compromised? What can I do to help you sleep? I work hard and work for cheap. Sometimes it's nothing but the way you're wired, and that's not your fault. We're all struggling with the world on fire. Now you've lost another friend who couldn't stay to see the end, 'cause he had somewhere else to be. Cut him down and burn the tree. There's no shelter from the rain, and I can't comprehend your pain. But I got arms and I got ears, and I will always be right here. And sometimes it's nothing but the way you were raised, and that could have been worse. I've seen you suffering through the best of days, and still you put me first. What can I do to let you know that I'm not haunted by his ghost? Let him dance around our room. Let him smell of your perfume. Share your best, remember when. And if he comes through here again, maybe he can make you laugh. Bring St. Peter's autograph. Thank you. Thank you.
I had a fiery background. Look at them.
Oh, wow. That's awesome. You guys look great.
Is that a Razorbacks hat?
I don't know, but it's
got
Jason. I can't
tell if it's mountains or...
He's got a Jason Isbell shirt on, so
yeah,
I'm good with it.
Yeah,
whatever.
You tune, and I'll look at people's hats while you tune. Oh, it's a hat. It's a mountain. Oh, they're kissing. Aw.
Aw.
Look at that.
Hey, guys. Man, I really appreciate y'all watching this. I know it's easier to sleep, but thank you for watching. Who's in the house?
Orlando.
Orlando. Good. I love Orlando. Is that Orlando? Do you mean the town, or is that Orlando Bloom behind the sign? No? She's looking. The town of Orlando,
yes.
Which I like a lot. I met Orlando Bloom one time. He was exhausted. He was so tired.
Maybe it's because there's how many O's are in his name.
I think that's what it is. He was like, oh. See, he'd been trying to write his name with an Etch-a-Sketch, and he was exhausted.
I was making more of like a joke about being on the lady side of it.
Oh,
like, oh,
I got you. Oh, Orlando Bloom. He is a beautiful man. I don't know if you guys are just now tuning in to my career. Some of you probably are. Some of you probably heard of me today. And for the first few times you heard of me on social media, it made you very angry. And finally, you're like, man, I'm just the right person said something. You're like, I'm just going to go ahead and listen to this record. So if you're just tuning in to me today.
He is the Fair Hogs man.
Yeah, I was. Me and Willie McNabb from Arkansas. But more importantly, I used to be a heavy drinker. And I quit drinking 8.5 years ago, and I have alluded to these things in my songs before, sometimes, you know, within the song, but I've never really written a full song for people who are in recovery. This is the first time I did that, and I set out to do it. I put a few inside jokes in there, and I did my best. I did my damnedest, because it's a hard road, man. It's a hard road. And I know it's really tough for some folks right now when you're locked in your house and you're trying to stay clean and sober. So we're rooting for you. We're rooting for you. You want to do it?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's do it. Last night I dreamed that I'd been drinking. Same dream I have about twice a week. I had a glass of wine, I woke up feeling fine, and that's how I knew it was a dream. Last night I dreamed that I'd been drinking. Cold burning whiskey down my throat. My hand turned into a rattlesnake, and I laughed myself awake, and that's how I knew it was a joke. It gets easier, but it never gets easy. I could say it's all worth it, but you won't believe me. Hold down your liquor, swallow your pride. You'd rather keep it inside. It gets easier, but it never gets easy. Last night I did myself a favor. I called in sick and went downtown. Drove past the local bar. A cop got behind my car. I wish he would pull me over now. Last night I let myself remember the times I forgot a woman's name. Blacked out behind the wheel. How tight the handcuffs feel. My daughter's eyes when she's ashamed. It gets easier, but it never gets easy. I could say it's all worth it, but you won't believe me. And you can't expect her to follow your lead.
gets easier, but it never gets easy.
I messed it up right at the very end. Do the solo again, and then I'll do that part. Ready? Gets easy. I could say it's all worth it, but you won't believe me. Hold down your liquor or swallow your pride. You'd rather keep it inside. It gets easier, but it never gets easy. It never gets easy.
Made it. We made it. Sometimes in the middle of a song, I will try to do something to demonstrate you all that I'm not just playing to backing tracks. That's what that was.
I think that's great. I also do. I just heard a background.
Somebody.
With you,
so. Woo! Somebody said, woo! Hey, yeah. Guys. Hey, guys. Y'all look great. What does that sign say?
I think it's her name.
Oh, is that your name? What's your name?
I think it was Erica, maybe.
Was it Erica? She didn't look excited when you said that. Hey, guys. Hey, guys. Hey, everybody. Oh, there's a palm. Hey. Man, you guys look great. I'm so glad I can see y'all. Yeah, you're hydrating. I think that's water. It's either water or vodka.
It doesn't matter what they're drinking.
Either way, she's hydrating. Good job.
What they're drinking.
Good job. That little kid right there rocks. Look at that little kid. That little kid is stoked. He's got some good hair and good cheeks. Is that a dog? Nice dog. That dog does not like my music. Look at that. Hey, puppy dog. Hello, puppy dog. He doesn't like my music. He's turned away from me.
I like that.
Man, you guys are great.
What's really awesome is that what you're commenting on is probably delayed, and so you're commenting
all
to
right.
people that are a little bit ahead, and so probably somebody thinks you're insulting them.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I did not mean to call your child a dog. There was a dog, and then there was a child.
Yeah.
You guys
happy Texas.
But either way, I just love you all. I love you all.
Tie-dye rules.
Well, this song will mark the conclusion of a performance tonight of the album reunions. Hopefully one day we will have an actual reunion. I didn't plan on that when I named the record this. Record was all done before the quarantine happened, but hopefully one day we will all be able to reunite and see each other again, and I'll get to see Jimbo Hart on the bass guitar.
Man, he was phenomenal.
Sadler Vaden on the electric guitar. Chad Gamble on the drums.
Grumpy
Derry
Chad.
Derry DeBoerhaw on the keys.
Happy Derry.
I love him so much, and I love my crew so much, and I miss him.
And thank you to Dave Cobb and Gina for helping
Dave
us
Cobb
make
and Gina
record.
Johnson for doing a fantastic job in the studio. Thanks to David Crosby. Thanks to our man Sam Gidley, our man Ben Erickson.
Zach.
You know. Yeah, thanks to Zach. Thanks to Kane for running the sound today. Thanks to everybody here at the Brooklyn Bowl. And yeah, this will close out the album. Nurse helped us buckle. Seat in the car and they sent us on our way. I drove home so slow. We had no instructions. The first days were hard, but there's things about babies a woman just knows. 3 in the morning, I lay my hand over your heart just to know you were safe in your sleep. When you started walking, I'd fight back the urge to stay right there beside you, keep you on your feet. And being your daddy comes natural. The roses
It's easy to see that you'll get where you're going, but the hard part is letting you go. The hard part is letting you go. It didn't take long to see you got the best of me in your mama's merciful heart in your eyes. And helping her raise you has taught me to see through the great fog of loneliness, the devil's disguise. And being your daddy comes natural. The roses just know how to grow. It's easy to see that you'll get where you're going, but the hard part is letting you go. The hard part is letting you go.
Play the fiddle.
To be someone's wife, and we walk down the aisle, and I'll give you away. But I wish I could walk with them back through your life to see every last minute of every last day. To hear your first words, to feel your first heartbreak, to sing you to sleep when you're scared of the dark. The best I can do is to let myself trust that you know who'll be strong enough to carry your heart. And being your daddy comes natural. The roses just know how to grow. It's easy to see that you'll get where you're going, but the hard part is letting you. The hard part is letting you go.
Amanda Shires on the fiddle and singing backgrounds. Thank you all so much. I'm Jason Isbell. I hope you've enjoyed this performance of Reunions. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for having us. We're having a blast, man. Beautiful room. I wish the people out there could see this place. It's really nice. When the time comes and it's safe to come to Nashville, not now, come to the Brooklyn Bowl, because it's cool. It's cool, man. My man Ricky Poss is in here. You in here, Ricky Poss? Yeah! Love you, dude. Ricky's been there since the start. Man. Tracy Thomas, my manager, thank you very much for everything. Tracy, to Jay and Thomas, thank y'all. And Andrew Colvin with his mustache. I've not seen it yet. I'm going to have to see that mustache, Andrew. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
Early.
That was for Dwight Schrute.
That was for Dwight Schrute. So, since we got time here, we're going to do a song that I did not write. And it's by the late, great Warren Zevon. We like to sing this song, don't we? You want to? One, two, three, four.
Yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum. Hoist the mainsail, here I come. Ain't no room on board for the ensign sea. You're my witness, I'm born to rock the boat. Some may sink, but we will float. Grab your coat, let's get out of here. You're my witness, I'm your mutineer. Long ago we laughed at shadows. lightning flashed, thunder followed. They could never find us here. You're my witness, I'm your mutineer. Some may sink, but we will float. Grab your coat, let's get out of here. You're my witness, I'm your mutineer. Yo ho ho, and a bottle of rum. Hoist the mainsail, here I come. Ain't no room on board for the insensate. You're my witness, I'm your mutineer. You're my witness, I'm your mutineer.
I think I added some extra time to that, but it was fun. I was enjoying myself. I didn't want to stop.
Your show. I'm here for
it. Well, it's a world show. And thanks again to Spotify for matching our donations to Music Cares. If you feel up to it, if you got a little extra laying around, please chip in, because part of what we're taking in is going to my crew on the road, and then the other half is going to Music Cares COVID-19 Relief Fund. And Spotify has been kind enough to agree to match everything that we donate to the Music Cares Fund. So, yeah, please, if you can and you're willing and you like what you see, even if you don't like what you see, please just give us some money.
And if you're feeling weird because you feel obligated and you don't have any means to do so, please don't.
Yeah, right. You know? When she was doing some shows streaming from the barn, she did like 30 of them in a row from our house, and it was called ISO Lounging. But she got so many emails from people apologizing for not being able to send money, and that was not the point. I mean, I appreciate people have good hearts, and I appreciate that. But
yeah, but also, seriously, nobody will know if you don't, but it will mean the world if you do.
Yeah.
And don't let any more harm yourselves.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
This is not the Baptist church next to where
yeah,
I grew up.
Exactly.
If you don't put anything
you're
in the plate,
you're not going to go to hell.
Nobody's going to give you a dirty look. But
but you know how it works. Like, some folks have more than others.
That's
and
right.
All that. Also, I'd like to thank again our essential workers. My sister's an essential worker.
Yes, she is.
We've got lots of friends that are, and all I can be is grateful and thankful for folks like y'all, because obviously our jobs aren't essential, but
yeah,
in a way, to me, they are.
Yeah, the part of our job that's essential is the part that we can do at home.
Yeah.
And so that I do, you know, and it helps me. I sit around, I play the guitar for 3 or 4 hours a day. I'm not going to kid y'all. It's I sit in the floor with headphones on, and that is essential to me.
If our music is getting you through, buy a copy.
Yeah.
You know.
Or donate to the Music Cares COVID Relief Fund. But yeah, thank you for what you do, because we depend on you, and you know, you're really important to us. And we realize that you're human, you know. People like her sister are just working so much, and sometimes when people in those positions get referred to as heroes, it's really, I mean, you are heroes and you're behaving heroically, but it's really easy to forget that those are human people too, that are having to go about their own day and have their own lives and try to keep themselves healthy and sane. So we love you guys and thank you very much. Hard on
keeps a hand on the gun. You can't trust anyone. I was so sure what I needed was more. Tried to shoot out the sun. And days when we raced, we flew off the page. Such damage was done. Oh, but I made it through. 'Cause somebody knew I was meant for someone. Girl, leave your boots by the bed. We ain't leaving this room 'cause someone needs medical help or the magnolias bloom. It's cold in this house. I ain't going out to chop wood. Cover me up and know you're enough to use me for good. I put your faith to the test when I tore off your dress in Richmond on high. Oh, but I sobered up and I swore off that stuff forever this time. And the old lover said I thought it'd be me who helped him get home. But home was a dream, one that I'd never seen till you. Cover me up and know you're enough to use me for good. Someone needs medical help or magnolias bloom. It's cold in this house. I ain't going out to chop wood. Cover me up and know you're enough to use me for good. Cover me up and know you're enough to use me for good.
That's Amanda Shires, and I'm Jason Isbell. Thank you all so much for listening.
Hope you guys have a great weekend. It's going to be a weird weekend, but that's okay. Thank y'all.
Thank y'all.
Is it going to be a weird weekend?
Yeah. It's going to be a weird
is
weekend.
It?
Yeah, I mean, not compared to last weekend. But
is
yeah.
it because of the storms?
It's because of the pandemic.
Oh, I thought you were talking about hurricanes.
I hope it's a weird weekend. Because it should, if it's the same as all your weekends used to be, you're going to get sick. So be careful. Be careful.
Thanks.
Happy record release.
Yay!
I can promise you there won't be a weirder one.
No.
Love you guys.
Love you guys. Thank y'all for being here.